Welcome, you are listening Radio Central News. I am Chandni and now news in detail. India's coronavirus cases crossed 57 lakh mark while over 46 lakh people have recovered from the pandemic, pushing the national recovery rate to 81.55% according to the data of Union Health Ministry. As many as 86,508 new cases in the past 24 hours added to the total cases of 57,32,519 as per the updated data. In fresh signs of slowdown in the contagion, India has begun to report more coronavirus recoveries each day than new patients. Patients cured till date now stands at 46,74,987 with the 87,374 fresh recoveries. The recovered cases exceed the 9,66,382 active cases by more than 37 lakh. Maharashtra, which remains the state hardest hit by the pandemic, also leads recovery with more than 20,000 patients have recovered in the past 24 hours. Andhra Pradesh contributes over 10,000 single-day recoveries, the data show. The active caseload now accounts for merely 16.86% of the total positive cases. 75% of the 86,508 COVID cases reported in the last 24 hours in the country are concentrated in 10 states and union territories including Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Delhi and Chhattisgarh. 9 more COVID-19 patients died in Himachal Pradesh on Thursday, pushing the death toll to 145, while 136 fresh cases took the state tally to 13,192. 6 deaths were reported from Kangra, 1 each from Shimla, Kullu, Chamba, according to the data provided by State Health Department this evening. Kangra has so far reported 37 deaths, Solan and Shimla 24 each, Mandi 20, Una 10, Sirmaur 9, Chamba 8, Hamirpur 6, Kullu 5 and Kinnaur and Bilaspur 1 each. A total of 236 patients recovered from the disease on Thursday. The total number of recoveries in the state stands at 9,173, while 10 people have migrated out of the state. Currently, there are 3,849 active COVID-19 cases in the state. The Congress on Thursday alleged that by passing the farm sector bill in Parliament, the government's objective is to abolish MSP and earn Rs. 1 lakh crore from the farming community. Addressing a joint press conference here, Congress spokesperson Abhishek Manu Singhvi and DPCC chief Anil Chaudhary alleged that the objective of bringing the bill is to implement the Shanta Kumar Committee report. The government, while not directly implementing the report of the Shanta Kumar Committee, has found a way to implement this report in a conspiratorial way through this law, Abhishek Manu Singhvi and Anil Chaudhary said. Attacking the government over the issue of MSP, Singhvi said, there is no clear cancellation of MSP, but they have not left any existence of MSP. You say you can go to this mandi if you want, you can also sell it on MSP, but what is the justification to say that you have not cancelled MSP? There is no mention of MSP, no criteria for pricing, despite that you are tricking the nation by saying that we have not removed MSP, the Congress spokesperson said. He said another point in contract farming. In 75 years, why didn't our constitution makers think about contract farming, the Congress spokesperson said. Now, there is no limit to the amount of paddy you can store. The government has changed that, he said. Talking about the recent happenings in Rajya Sabha during passage of farm bills, the Congress spokesperson said, I want to say 2 points in contest of what happened in Rajya Sabha. I want to ask directly if there was quorum or not. Half the people were sitting on one side. Then who checked the quorum? 5 to 7 people asked for division in front of me, but nobody paid heed. Slamming the opposition parties, including the Congress, Union Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar on Wednesday said they have nothing to say on agriculture bills, hence spreading lies on the minimum support price. The MSP is not a party of any law. Congress has nothing to say on agriculture bills, hence spreading falsehood on MSP, he said, adding that the MSP was an administrative decision of the government earlier and is even today. Addressing reporters at the party headquarters here, Mr. Tomar said MSP of Kharif and Rabi crops has been declared. Lashing out at the Congress, he said, good people in Congress are being ignored. People who have leadership in their hands have no status left in the country. No one in the party listens to them, so they try to mislead the country, he said. He questioned the principal opposition party for not making a provision for MSP in the farm bills when they were in power for long. People who ruled for 50 years are asking why we didn't make a provision for MSP in the farm bills. If a law was necessary for MSP, why didn't they bring it in 50 years, he said. Mr. Tomar said MSP is an administrative decision of government and it will continue. Extending losses for the sixth consecutive session on Thursday, the BSE Sensex crashed by 1,114.82 points to settle at 36,553.60 as selling was seen across the board amid weak Asian market. The Nifty of National Stock Exchange too fell by 326.30 points at 10,805.55 points. In opening trade, the Sensex declined by 386 points to 37,282.18. Till the end of the session, it was dropped 1,173 points to 36,495.98, days low, before closing at 36,553.60, tumbling down by 1,114.82 points from its previous close. The Sensex registered a high and low at 37,304.26 and 36,495.98 points respectively. The Nifty recorded a high and low at 11,015.30 and 11,790.20 points respectively. The sectoral indices like IT, technology, auto, metal and realty slid between 3-4%. In scrips, Indusland Bank was the major loser, down by 7.24 PC, followed by Bajaj Finance, Tech Mahindra, TCS and M&M. That is all for the today's news bulletin. Stay tuned to Radio Central News for more updates.